In Jesus' name.
Amen.
What a wonderful word. What do we say to Bishop Johnson?
God bless,
God bless you. And give a very big clap offering. Give a very big clap offering. Amen. I believe that by the end of this conference, the higher personality will fight every personality troubling your life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That's a powerful one. I think that your junction, not to surprise, maybe in the next few years, I'll come and show you a book. The personality that admits a personality. I like things like this. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. So, this is how I tell my books. Higher personality. Amen. It was a very wonderful word from an experienced man of God. And I believe that if we can incorporate these things in our practices, we are going to be very active and effective in all our endeavors as Christians. And we will be very mindful of the decisions we take. And very sensitive to things that happen in our environment. Hallelujah. Very, very important. Things that happen in our environment. Because I always tell people that your answer is in the hands of somebody. God will not come from heaven. One day there was a lady that was crying that she needed a son, the doctor's son. And she was talking plainly, she was praying all kind of prayer and making noise. And I was listening to music. Then I asked someone, what is your problem? They said, I need money to pay my daughter's school. I said, can you take the money and leave me to listen to my music and meditate? So God will not come from heaven to give you a car, but God will use someone by your side to give you that car. So if you don't, the problem in the church today as human relationship. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I believe that the speakers will address these issues. Human relationship. We don't know how to deal with people. We don't know how to talk to people. We don't know how to relate to people. Sometimes they intimidate you with your titles. Don't you know I'm a bishop? You are a bishop, I agree. But I'm also the associate pastor. I fix the instrument for you to come and preach. You are the bishop, but I'm the usher. I usher the people to the church before you preach. I agree. You are the bishop, I agree. But we give the offering for us to build the cathedral. So we too, we are important. You are the bishop. I take your clothes in the laundry. You are the bishop. I drive you to the program. I take the camera. I put this on the Facebook. I agree. So when you are talking to me, you are the bishop. But remember, without me, no Facebook. Clap your hands. You are the bishop. You can only drive automatic car. The V8 is manual. Okay, with that, we will see how you go to that conference. So, you are the bishop. So, I agree. So, although we are senior pastors, we are bishop, we should know that the people in the pews are as important as us. Hallelujah.
Yeah,
because when the bishop came and there was no microphone, they can't preach. I came first to fix the microphone, make sure the place was sweet. Everything was safe, so they came, they can preach. Okay, tomorrow I will come and fix it though. I'm the bishop. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm very excited. Clap your hands. Clap your hands. I'm very excited. I love the word. I don't know about you. But I want to take this opportunity to properly introduce the bishops and the men of God we have in the house. And I'm very privileged that there are some vice chancellors who don't really know their students. So maybe today they will know their students. They don't even know their students, now they are their students. And they are here. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, I want us to acknowledge the presence of Reverend Dr. Antony Walto from Dubai. Clap your hands. Clap your hands. Yes. I just was Amen. Yes, our miss, you'll be speaking to us briefly. And then we also have Reverend Professor Chris Sidney, the Vice Chancellor of Rescue Nations Theological University, USA. Africa Satellite Campuses. Amen. So when I finish with my PhD thesis, that is where I will sit with you one-on-one. So then you will know that the student was the MC of the program. Hallelujah. Amen. And then we also have Bishop. Forget me. Forgive me. This RIP, I'll come back to you. Let me say it very well. Amen. We have my good friend, Bishop Dr. McPherson in the house. As the senior pastor of Life Covenant Bible Church International. Worry in Nigeria. Every time you hear the name Worry, two things come into mind. Hallelujah. No, I'm in Nigeria. I was brought up in Worry. My father used to work for Chevron. So, what happened in Worry? All the better states, my state, from Accord to Ibuzo to Asaba. Oh, that is my state. So, when you hear Worry, it is the city of Oye and Troubles. Amen. So, every pastor for Worry is violent. No pastor for Worry is gentle because there's no gentle spirit in Worry. Hello? No Ajibota in Worry. Everybody worries Ajibota. Mama sit now, as I was brought up there, she did it for you. Amen. So for you to have a church and succeed in Worry, there you got all you. Amen. So there are some people who are gone for me, I have gone for Lagos and Abuja. God knows. We take it for that one, I will consider. But Worry. Hallelujah. He is gone for Worry, so let him say that we're happy. With all the prayers, we'll support you. Let me say it. I'm from Abuja and for Lagos, and maybe for Takot. I don't get that anointing. Make everybody know. So that you don't transfer me go on. Hallelujah. And then our speaker who just finished, Bishop Dr. Johnson, a Greater Heights Ministry, is the senior pastor. Amen. And then I have my papa, the fair slim gentleman. He's very gentle. Yesterday I saw him come bless us. This man looks like he's an angel. But the way he's taking steps, let me watch first. So when I touch him and I saw that it was not an angel, but the human being, I say, praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Bishop Dr. Charles. Let's acknowledge his presence. He's the senior pastor of Anointed Brethren Church Incorporated, Nigeria. Amen. And then we have, thank you, the governor of the Nigerians in this country. Do you know him? You want to see that governor? You know him? Yesterday he told me he wants to eat kokote first of all. He said, if I don't give him first of all, he will bundle me and put me in prison.
Don't worry.
I'm telling you. We're in trouble. Hallelujah. He's a very good man, very friendly, very kind, very respectful. And we must learn from all these senior ministers. Is in the person of Bishop Onat Eze.
Christian church is based in Lagos, the city of fashion.
No,
I've already invited myself.
You're welcome.
So you have to welcome me. I've invited myself. No.
Since Lagos and Abuja is your own choice.
Yes. And maybe in Lagos, you have to take me to Lekki, to VGC. You know that. All those places, now they belong. I don't belong to Jimo and all those places. No, No, I go still for VGC Conference. That will go back. Hallelujah. That's very awesome. Thank you. Amen. And then we have another bishop in our midst. Let me get it. Bishop is Bishop Imokio. With this one, you have to eat before you. This man, let me know his head. Amen.
Amen.
That's Bishop Peter Imokio. He's the founder of Ama, of God's Anointed Ministry, Nigeria. Amen.
Amen.
So, clap your hands and receive them. I love them. I love them. Amen. I mean, I love Nigerians, whether you like it or not. Yeah, I love them. That word from one of the seasoned men of God is well traveled. I don't really know how God formed him. He's an Indian, born in Malaysia, citizen of Malaysia, but he's a resident of Dubai. No, how can you buy this? An Indian who was born in Malaysia became a citizen of Malaysia, but he's resident in Dubai. So I don't know how to, whether he's an Indian, he's a Malaysian, but all that we know is that he's coming from a country. Hallelujah. Whether India or Malaysia or Dubai, I don't know. Hallelujah. Malaysia is a very good place. That was where I studied. I studied there, so I know the country very well. It's a very nice place. I attended the University of Malaysia. That was where I did my LLB. It's a good country. So for you to live there and go to Dubai, you know that there's something. That's why I told Bishop Eze yesterday, let me give you a ticket to go to Dubai. It's good. I'm telling you, you will carry anointing, tablet anointing, laptop anointing, all those are, they are necessary.
Yes.
God, yes, in the name of Jesus. So with a standing ovation and then a big round of applause, let's receive the ministry.
So if I have to travel, I have to have a passport. So when I apply for the passport, just with my parents I can get, I can apply for an Indian passport. So I apply, I receive an Indian passport, so citizen of India. Now for almost 16-20 years I'm in Dubai, connected with Dubai. I've got two children, one boy and girl, both married and got children, and all are settled in Malaysia, in Dubai. And myself, my wife, I with my children. Why? Normally I say this wherever I go, because Dubai is a hub where you find all the embassies and the consulates. For me, just 5 minutes drive, 10 minutes drive, 15 minutes drive, I can get to the consulate and get the visa and fly around the world wherever the Lord leads me. Amen?
Amen.
For the last 46 months, I've traveled around about 286,000 air miles with the good news to Uganda, Kenya, Zimbabwe, Ghana, Cameroon, South Africa, Nigeria, Malaysia, UK, US, Australia. See, I've been to all these countries, but the only thing which I feel bad when I reach home is I weep along with my wife for what I see in the midst of the churches. Amen?
Amen.
That's what I was saying. When you say 30 minutes, then there is a problem. But still, I know the Holy Spirit will lead me. Thank you. Be seated.
Amen.
I give thanks to my Lord for, I think, almost everybody are bishops. Amen?
Amen.
What is lacking in our midst, in the sense in our churches, is the Holy Spirit. Amen?
Amen.
People have not understood what Holy Spirit is. They speak about Holy Spirit, they say they have received the Holy Spirit, but what do you mean by Holy Spirit? Amen?
Amen.
So, people say speaking in tongues is Holy Spirit. Is it so? Even you cannot understand, even the church cannot understand. I feel that even the Lord Almighty cannot understand. Amen?
Amen.
But that is not Holy Spirit. It's a gift of the Holy Spirit. But I'm asking about what is Holy Spirit? That is lacking. Churches don't come together. Now you say you have a meeting here. There are so many churches while I was coming from my road to this place. There are the people. Because that pastor or that church doesn't want to come and join with you. So that means the Holy Spirit in you doesn't want to bring people together. They are separating it. So what kind of Holy Spirit are you holding? Oh. Amen?
Amen?
Are you getting what I'm saying?
Yep, absolutely.
So, I'm going to bring that Holy Spirit now here.
Amen.
Because I'm holding it, I'm tasting it, that is why the Lord is opening the way where I'm traveling around the world. And you may feel that I'm rich because I'm in Dubai. See, I tell you, for the last 17 years I'm not working at all. I don't run a business also. In my name, I don't have any income to travel around. But my children are the person, without my knowledge, looks after my ticket and my visa cost and expense. And they have been blessed in such a manner. They are only 34 years. And they have been blessed in such a manner. The salary is very high, the position is very high. They get a good income. And accommodation is in a four-star hotel we stay. Amen?
Amen.
So the Lord is, we don't go for the money. When we are doing the Lord's work sincerely, what you need is will follow you. That's what my experience is. Now, when we say about Holy Spirit, when Jesus Christ was baptized, it is mentioned in the Bible that the Holy Spirit came as a dove, landed on him. Why is it not happening nowadays? Amen? Even I doesn't know the answer. If somebody can give me an answer, of course I want to learn from you, we talk so. Okay, next. During the Pentecostal day, the disciples received the Holy Spirit. It was like a fire, come, divided the two, landed on them. And then why is it not happening in during our days? Amen?
Amen.
Am I speaking something wrong?
Yes.
So, this June, maybe that is the son of Lord Almighty, the second one chosen by Jesus Christ. Okay, maybe you get the answer when you reach that. But now, we say that we have been baptized. It is a repentance baptism which is taking place. So-and-so pastor baptized us and so-and-so person baptized us. But have you seen the Holy Spirit? The word of God in Apostle Acts, it says, have you received the Holy Spirit? So they were saying that we have not heard about it. So what is the baptism you receive? It's water baptism. It's a repentance where you have done that. Now you are supposed to receive the Holy Spirit baptism. Amen?
Amen.
Have you received it? I got 30 minutes. I'm just on the first layer. Amen?
Amen.
Just because the Holy Spirit is not working in us, that is why we say that we don't give permission to the Holy Spirit. Let the Holy Spirit lead him. No. We say that we stick to the commercial thing. 30 minutes, 40 minutes, 1 hour. Amen? But if we have an offering, we have 1 hour for that. Maybe 5 times offering in one meeting.
Yeah. Absolutely.
So you don't require Holy Spirit for that. But a person who wants to come spending around about 4,000, you are feeding for the flight and for the visa cost has got doubled now. And when he comes, he gets 30 minutes, 40 minutes, 50 minutes. I cry inside me. I'm not able to speak. I'm blaming the person who said 30 minutes. It is happening everywhere. So the speaker, he spends the money. But if the money was spent by the host, he will try his level best to maximum utilize it because he is not spending money from his pocket. If the host is spending the money. So, okay, you do 30 minutes, finish. Amen?
Amen.
I'm not able to speak. Blocking it. Who is blocking? We say the evil spirit is blocking. No, the church is blocking. So, Bishop was speaking about something which is coming from outside. No, it is already inside.
Yeah.
Yeah. It is among your church. It is in the body of Christ. And which is the body of Christ? We, the body, the Christ. It is already inside us. We are restricted. We are saying this. So where is the Holy Spirit? Is it the Holy Spirit who is guiding you? If the Holy Spirit is guiding, signs and wonders will take place in front of you. I give thanks to my Lord for wherever He takes me. When I speak from the Word of God, what has been spoken from the Word of God, He says there is life. The Word of God is life. We are speaking regarding the life to the complete. And when we say, we may not say that it took place during Jesus Christ's time. It is happening within right now. And it is happening in front of me. Amen?
Amen.
I hope you are getting what I am saying.
Yes.
So, during the Pentecostal day, when they received the Holy Spirit, and they started speaking in tongues, so the churches feel that when you receive the Holy Spirit, it is tongue. No. Holy Spirit is different and tongue is different. In the book of Acts, chapter 19, verse 5, it says, when Paul raised his hand, when he laid his hand, there were 12 people over there, and they received the Holy Spirit, and they spoke in tongues, and they prophesied. So three things took place. So they received the Holy Spirit, they have received the gift of tongues, and then they received the gift of prophecy. During Pentecostal day, they receive the gift of, receive the Holy Spirit, and then they receive the gift of tongues. Why tongues was given during that day? Why is it not possible to give a healing gift? Because during the Pentecostal day, the world came over there. The faithful servants came over there. It was from Russia, it was from Japan, it was from Ghana, it was from Nigeria. They, each and every country, they used to speak in different languages. But when Lord do something, it is miracle. We use that word miracle. Because when divine things are happening, that word is used as miracle. So, During the time when the disciples received the Holy Spirit, the first gift was tongues. And when the people rushed to the place, they saw that they were speaking something. And people were just listening. And I was like, hello, he is speaking my language. Then this person said, no, he is speaking my language. I can understand. So one person speaking, but with different languages which can be understood by the different people who was listening to what they were speaking. Amen?
Amen.
That's a miracle. That is what we call tongues. Not what we say in churches and we say that it is tongues. And if it is tongues, the word of God says so. If you have received the gift of tongues, pray that you receive the gift of interpretation also. Why should not mention that if you have received the gift of prophecy or anything like that, to pray for something? But for tongues, it has clearly mentioned, pray that you receive the gift of interpretation. So why was that mentioned? Because tongue is connected with interpretation. And in 1 Corinthians chapter 14, it clearly says that if you are talking in tongues, it's a prophecy. And if there is no interpreter, just see whether there is an interpreter. If there is no interpreter, be silent in the church. Why is it that we are not teaching that? Or we know that he doesn't want to do it. So that means you are hiding something. So if you are hiding something, that means inner you, what you say, that the Holy Spirit is guiding me, not at all. If it is the Holy Spirit speaks straight. Even if it is bishop or overseer or anybody. I have got so many dissertations in front of me. I have not declared it. I was just watching when your MC was speaking. Bishop so-and-so, running so-and-so church, so-and-so king, and all this. In my case, he had a doubt. How come Malaysia, India, Dubai? And I used to say that you are getting 3 persons from 3 countries as 1 person in your midst.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
So, whatever, wherever I go, I carry my video and my digital camera. Why? Because the world is such, if I go and tell that during my meeting this took place, then they will ask, you are just saying, how sure that it has taken place or not? Whatever the video has been taken, I without editing, upload in YouTube and Facebook, so that the people can see what exactly has taken place during my meetings. Amen?
Amen.
So the Holy Spirit, and I used to say that, don't push. That is a system now, it is going in the world. People want to push. Why do you want to push? You just stand, and if you are taking the word of God, it's life. If you are talking about the word of God, and if you are talking about the spirit of the Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit is going to do that, not you. Amen?
Amen.
Why I boldly say is, when I lay the hand, I know that I am just like you people. I am not extraordinary. But I know the spirit in me is something different than what you people think. When I lay the hand, I see people receiving the Holy Spirit. I see people receiving the gift of the Holy Spirit. I see people going down. I see people, the evil spirit are shouting and going away. I did not push them. I did not even force them. It's happening. And I am surprised. When I come to my room, I give thanks to my God. Lord, you're using me like this. Amen?
Amen.
And I want you two people. Don't be just like a bishop or overseer or senior pastor. Just raise your hand. Lay your hand. This will take place in you, within you, in front of you. Amen.
Amen.
How many of you believe in that? Amen.
Amen.
So, that is the spirit. So which spirit is that? Which Holy Spirit is that? Gospel of John verse 14 and chapter 14 verse 14 it says, you ask me anything in my name, I will do it for you.
Amen.
Jesus Christ was saying, you can ask anything in his name and he is giving a promise that he will do it for you. But nobody is asking in his name. They are asking for his own name. If you asking in His name, that means you have to obey His commandments. Once you start obeying His commandments, if you ask, He has said, I will do it for you. And the verse 15 says, I ask my Father, and He is going to give you another comforter who will be with you and inside you. The Spirit, the Holy Spirit which you are talking is just following you. And some occasion if the Holy Spirit says you are not doing right, but you say, no, I am doing right. Because your eagerness is for something and you are doing it. But when you receive this another comforter, when that is inside you, you will not be in a position to do something wrong. Because the power, the another comforter is already inside you. Amen.
Amen.
Receive that. Receive that.
Amen.
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 The Lord God says. Amen.
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 The Lord God says. Listen, praise the Lord. To the Lord. Not to any of you. Just you and the Lord. He says that I want to fill you with the power of the Holy Spirit. And when you receive that power, I'm going to give you the gift of the Holy Spirit. Amen?
Amen.
The gift of speaking in prophecy. The Lord says, are you ready to receive it? Are you ready to receive it? You and Jesus Christ and nobody else. And nobody else, and nobody else, and nobody else, and nobody else. But say it in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
The Lord God says, there are so many in front of me which is coming in front of me. Standing here, I cannot see anybody's face. It's dark. But when the Holy Spirit is forcing me to come and touch you, that's why I just came. But I give thanks for what He's doing through me.
Amen.
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 Receive that power.
Amen.
Receive that power.
Receive it.
When there is a meeting which is taking place in the church, when the power is there, you don't bring artificial things to your church. Don't make the people believe that you are something extra. But make the people believe that it is not extra. He is anointed with that Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
And when there is a meeting which is taking place in the neighboring church, make yourself and your church to go and see what is happening over there. If it is the word of God, if that has not been taught in your church, let the people take it from there. Amen.
Amen.
If you are not going, how can you expect them to come this time? Amen.
Amen.
When they start moving, that means the Holy Spirit is already in you. Amen.
Amen.
Shout hallelujah.
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 Amen.
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 Yes. The Lord God says, this is not enough at all. I've already poured the power inside you. And till now you have not recognized it. But be bold enough. The gift is already inside you. And if you start moving, and when you speak from your tongue, that is a prophecy, which is going to take place among them, where they will be shouting to the Lord Almighty, giving thanks. Are you ready to go forward? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, receive
Amen.
In Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Can you give a clap of it to the Lord Almighty? Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. So, thank you, Jesus.
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 Thank you, Jesus, for giving me this opportunity. And I pray that those who are present today, fill them with what you have entrusted to me and which has already spoken to them. It's not me who is putting that in them. I know, Lord, you are going to do that. Let them taste it. Let them shout to the world what they have received. Let the sign and wonders follow. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. for this one. Say it. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Clap your hands. Hallelujah. Clap your hands. Amen. What should we say to Dr. Antony? What should we say? God bless you. Give him a round of applause. I gave him 30 minutes. He ministered for 20 minutes. So he has given me 10 minutes back. I salute you for that. I want you to tell him, I love Kanes. You serve God. God is in heaven, but one thing, tell your people, time.
No.
He said, I can trust the Ghanaian Christian for anything and everything, but time, not yet. Hallelujah. And that is a problem. If we have to fit into this modern globalization, we need to be time conscious. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 I'm not hearing your voices. I didn't hear that one. Hallelujah.
Amen.